Fortify integrates well with GitHub. In this section, we're going to show how to set up Fortify scanning, including pull request-based scanning, and look at the results in the GitHub IDE. Here we have a repository containing the simple 8-ball sample application. Let's add Fortify scanning to the setup. Go to security, code scanning alerts, add a new scanning tool, and we'll add Fortify on-demand scanning. I'll largely leave this as is, but instead of having this time-based trigger, I'm going to add a pull request-based trigger so I can show that functionality later on as well. Committing this new workflow will also immediately trigger it because it by itself is a push to the branch. And that's a good thing because to do pull request-based scanning, we do need to have a baseline to get started with. So let's just get started. Then if we go to actions, we see that this has created a workflow run. Can have a look at this one. It's currently setting up the job as we see. It will now download the relevant Fortify tools. It will do a regular build of this project. Then it will upload the source files to Fortify on demand for a static scan as well as for a composition analysis scan using Sonatype. And then it will get results back into GitHub. This will take a few minutes here, which is quite typical for a small microservice. In case customers want to do pull request-based scanning on larger applications, we have a functionality called Speed Dial, which allows them to trade off scan depth for scan speed, which is often appropriate in that context. For now, we'll wait a few minutes for the results to become ready. Fortify on demand is done scanning. The results are now being exported from Fortify on demand and then imported into the GitHub repository, allowing us to see the results right there. There it is. Here now under security, code scanning alerts, we see the Fortify finding that we have an unreleased resource streams. Now we have this baseline of scanning. Let's try to create a pull request. I'm going to do the Java editing directly in the GitHub interface here for simplicity. Let's remove the finding that we had. So we're making this fixed. The path manipulation vulnerability is no longer there. And let's create something else. Maybe read a password and write it to the console. Now, we're not going to commit this directly to master, but instead we're going to create a pull request. So GitHub says it can merge this with the main branch, but it's also triggering a Fortify scan because we configured that when setting up this workflow. Now, let's look at the details again. Going to the same process again, we'll have to wait for a few minutes for this scan to complete. Job is done. We can now start looking at the pull requests. Checks have run. They're all green because we didn't select to break the build based on the findings. We can, however, see that we have this privacy violation now occurring in the code that was specific to the pull request. This concludes our demo of GitHub scanning with Fortify.